fourth. She was nominated by both Dave Gove and Melissa for the fourth, so.
So I'm here today to speak about Dr. Mark Thomas, who was very instrumental in the development of the computer science, computer engineering, and electrical engineering departments here at Cal State Bakersfield. Just a little bit of background, Mark joined CSUB in 1981 as part of the mathematics department, and so that's why he was jointly nominated for this award by both the mathematics and the computer science and computer electrical engineering departments. He was a very accomplished researcher in mathematics, and I apologize to my math colleagues out there. I'm going to probably butcher the name of his research area, but he did research in, I believe it's Bonk algebra? Banach algebra. Okay, so see, as I said, I'm butchering the name of the algebra. He did research in the caliber of an R1 institution. He was very prolific in publications and mathematical journals, very respected mathematical journals. Received several NSF grants in a very competitive research division where only about 5% of those grants are awarded. And most notably, he, in 1988, wrote a paper that proved the Singer-Rumor conjecture. That was an open problem in mathematics since 1955. And he wrote the proof that proved that conjecture. And as a result of that publication, he was invited to many prestigious universities. I'm not going to name all of them, but just a few big names. Oxford, Leeds University, UC Berkeley, UCLA, and many others of that caliber to talk about his research. So we were very fortunate to have him here as a top-notch mathematics researcher at CSU Bakersfield. With respect to the computer science and engineering departments, as I said, he was just foundational in the formation of those departments. I have several of my colleagues here that can attest to the fact that our department would not be what it is today without the dedication and effort that Mark put into not only the programs, but forming the faculty, mentoring the students, and just being such a part of our program for so many years. The curriculum that he developed is still in use today by faculty members. Obviously, it's been updated for the modern times, but they're still using it in operating systems and networking. Just to give a little anecdote, I actually was a student here before I went off to graduate school to become a faculty member. And when I was a student, Mark taught our digital circuits class. And I can remember all of us being in there just kind of astounded by how brilliant he was at digital circuits. Here's a mathematician who's teaching an engineering class and knowing every single thing he's talking about. Every single diagram was detailed, and we're furiously writing on our papers, trying to keep up with him as he's writing all these circuit diagrams on the whiteboard, and just going a mile a minute. And then one of the students got a digital camera, which in the 1990s was a luxury item to have a digital camera. And we were thrilled. We're like, we're going to become best friends with this student because he has a digital camera, and he can record all these intricate diagrams that Mark is putting up on the whiteboard that we're trying to frantically write down on paper. That just gives you an idea, as a student, how impactful he was on my career. And just in general, he was well-regarded by the students. There was a kind of a joke or a meme that our students had that if Mark was an academic superhero, his superpower would be to divide by zero, which, from a mathematical perspective, is an impossibility. And as I was speaking with one of the former students who's now a faculty member the other day, we were talking about Mark, and he said, not only would he figure out how to divide by zero, but he would explain it in such a way that I would then know how to divide by zero at that point too. And so it was just a real force to be reckoned with within our department. And when we talk about the engineering programs, I honestly believe that if it were not for Mark's efforts and dedication and sheer force of will to get those programs started, we probably would not have the ABET accredited engineering programs that we have today. It was really his dedication to electrical and computer engineering that got those programs off the ground, and that gave a nice foundation that the department was able to pick up with and move on from after he retired. And one other little anecdote here, which the faculty member will know, Mark, for many, many is a top-notch mathematical researcher and a great academic and a teacher and a mentor. He also did a staff job, essentially, as doing system administration for the department. And he would run this land watch, which is a way of looking for attackers attacking the networks, which back in the 80s and 90s, not many people knew what an attacker was. They didn't know what's a hacker, what's a cyber attacker, what's cyber attacks, what's cyber security. But Mark was on the cutting edge of that. He would notice things before campus IT would notice it. He would let people know what's going on. He would get annoyed when people didn't quite understand the magnitude of what he was trying to tell them. Because, like, wait, they're trying to attack our networks. We should stop this. We should prevent this. But just at the time frame, it wasn't really a big impact on the systems there. Just to kind of wrap up things, as I said, we really do miss Mark. We're very glad that his family's here to join us today. His sister, brother-in-law, and nephew have joined us today from the Bay Area for this induction. Want to leave with one more final anecdote, which is that even after Mark retired, he was still active in the department. He would log into our department server on almost a daily basis, and he would be keeping an eye on things, and Steve Garcia, who's our current system administrator, and myself would get emails all the time about things that weren't working quite right, or things that weren't working at all. One time he even had to manually edit the school file, which is how you would normally have a system send you an email, but he crafted an email to myself and Steve because the system wasn't working, the email program wasn't working, and he wanted us to know because he knew that the semester, excuse me, at that point it was the quarter, he knew the quarter was starting in 2 days, and there's something wrong with the server, and even though he wasn't teaching, he knew it needed to get fixed so they'd be ready for the students when the quarter started that Monday. And he handcrafted this message to Steve and I on Friday night to let us know, hey, there's something wrong with the server. You guys need to look into it. And that's just how dedicated he was to this campus, that even after he retired, he logged in, he kept an eye on things, he kept us up to date, and he made sure that everything was going forward well for the students and for the department as a whole. So I'm very honored to have nominated Mark Thomas with the full unanimous support of the Computer Science Department for this award.
Him every day, as I know his colleagues do. Thank you.